very promising ground to not only to make this workshop successful with the exhibition of new products, but also to replicate this experience with other companies and in other communities. So basically, as UNIDO is a facilitator and is a knowledge-based organization, our role is simply to mobilize what we have gained in other projects in other part of the world,
yes.
Mobilize expertise, resources, and bring them and adapt them to the Egyptian context. And this is proving to be successful. I've been attending this workshop, and I've seen that new interesting products are coming up. And the most important aspect also that I would like to stress is the fact that most of the participants are women.
Mm-hmm.
Young people,
mm-hmm.
and
so you're supporting women here, or just by mere chance, you know, they're just
yeah, exactly. So the development aspect of mm-hmm. Of this activity is extremely important. In general, UNIDO, of course, being let's say one technical agency in support of the development of small and medium enterprise, we have we always in all projects if not all of the projects supporting MSME, we introduce an element of creativity and innovation. So this explains why, I mean, we are now on board and we are joining efforts with the IMC. And we look forward to replicate in other areas the success for the results and the lesson learned from this workshop.
How do you qualify when you sign up the works of the artisans, you know, that are here in Egypt, the Egyptian ones? How do you qualify them? How do you see them?
Well, the pre-existing skills and cultural assets and the cultural heritage is one of the major inputs to the craft creative industry value chain. So these are the inputs that are largely available in Egypt because of the immense cultural heritage that Egypt has. So I see that there is a lot of potential to promote the Egyptian craft industry, craft creative industry value chain, also by addressing, okay, we have the inputs. Of course, the value chain includes also an element which has to do with the manufacturing process, because
yes.
There is a sort of even processing of raw material which needs to be addressed, and this is where we are, UNIDO is involved. So it's basically product design and development. Mm-hmm. Then there is the third element, which is extremely equally important and crucial, which is the marketing element. The marketing intelligence needs to feed continuously the whole value chain, and I think this is what IMC is doing extremely well by bringing the companies, accompanying them to international exhibitions,
yes.
Organizing events whereby the products can be exhibited and promoted. So I think we are trying, in this project to address all the three elements that will be able to promote and to support the development of this value chain.
Well, let me ask you one question before turning to Mr.
Yes.
Nadim. Do you have an experience like that in Italy? Something that was the same sort of the category that your project like here?
Because our clients, of course, in Italy, I have experience only being an Italian,
yeah.
But
not doing that word there.
But as UNIDO, we have a large number of projects in the same area, promotion of creative industry, in Nicaragua, in Vietnam,
yes.
in Thailand, and in Pakistan also, and in Iran. where it was this international, let's say this international experience showed us that the promotion of this sector is also in economic terms extremely, extremely significant. The global, the value of the global trade in handicrafts amounts to $200 billion, with India and Thailand being the major actors in this global trade.
Yeah.
Plus, of course, it cannot be underestimated the development, let's say, impact of promoting the craft sector, because most of the companies belonging to this sector are more micro, small and medium enterprises. So it's a new opportunity for income generation and also for employment creation. So the experience of other projects told us that this is the right direction, and that there is a need also at institutional level to support the craft sector.
Yes.
Just not to see, let's say, the craft sector or the creative industry, perceive them or only being linked to culture, to their cultural nature, but also to see what is their potential for economic value and economic growth.
Well, Mr. Nadeem, how do you recruit your artists? You know, like how, you know, if someone you like is doing, do they approach you or you approach them? How do you go about that, getting those artists and discovering them?
Let me give you some background on how this workshop is developing or developed.
Yes.
We have a group of artists where and craftsmen where we see potential. We work with people that have potential for growth, people who are willing to engage in the internationalization of their art and craft, people who are willing to go the extra mile and do extra work to approach new markets, people who want to innovate, people who want to excel, and people who have the ability to manage others and to create a network for themselves, because in traditional arts and crafts, a lot of it is handmade.
Yes.
A lot of it relies on the skill of the artisan himself. It is not to our benefit to take somebody out to an international fair, exhibit his product, and sell one piece of that.
Mm-hmm.
We want him to be able to sell 5, 10, 100 thousands
and keep
of
creating
those.
And be creating.
And once
more,
he
yeah.
has an order for quantities, he has to have the ability to engage more people with him to do that, to teach them to get that on board. So that is one of the main criterias.
Yes.
We are looking for people who can command and orchestrate a group. So that is one. Coming from the design part, to introduce design into this and to introduce design that addresses the outside world,
mm-hmm.
this is where we needed UNIDO. UNIDO mobilized designers from Spain, from Italy, from Croatia, and brought them in to this workshop to work with around 30 Egyptian companies
mm-hmm.
Engaged in traditional arts and crafts.
So they are companies, they're not individuals coming?
No, they are small companies,
small
enterprises.
Yes.
Small enterprises. Some of them are young entrepreneurs. Some of
what
them
do you call micro industries or something like that?
Not necessarily micro, because the definition of micro can be misleading here. These are people working in the crafts, arts and crafts business.
Yes.
Regardless of their size. And size is not an issue when we're discussing arts and crafts.
Okay.
We will not penalize a large establishment working in the arts and crafts because they're large.
Mm-hmm.
Arts and crafts is something we want to grow with. We want them all to be large. And as I said in the beginning, job creation in this sector can be very fast and very cheap.
Yes.
Given that we provide a market for the product. So this is.
But then this is you are doing the work,
yes,
the part of providing
yes,
a market,
yes.
which is very difficult. Marketing is
first,
very important.
First, we have to work on the design element.
Mm-hmm.
Now, because we know that design is a lengthy process,